Hello everyone, my name is Duke of the Bump. I'm delighted to see you. Welcome to a brand new series which I am calling Itch House. This will be hopefully a daily series in which I take a look at some random games from the website itch.io, or if you prefer itch.io. Itch.io is a free website where anyone can upload a game, or really a book, or a song, or an art asset, or any independent creative project, really. I guess it doesn't even really have to be independent. I mean, EA could upload a game to itch.io, I guess, if they wanted to. Anyone can do it. I uploaded some games there. I found some really awesome games there. And this is an idea I've had kicking around for a while. And the reason I'm starting the series is because after Castle Game Jam, I kind of realized how much fun it is to just sit down and dive into some games completely sight unseen. I've sort of explored this concept before with the random game generator, but it's a little different with older console games because a lot of games from that era aren't really that playable today, and a lot of them, you know, they would have required the manual to figure out how to play them. Hopefully, most of these games will have built-in instructions or instructions on the website. I actually have the website for the first game up here, and the name of this game is Super Treeman with an exclamation point, and the description is: defend yourself against lumberjacks, but hippies will help you, smiley face. And this is a prototype. This is by Vanston on itch, vanston.itch.io, and I will link to this game in the description. I will be taking requests for the series, so if you are a game developer and you have a free game on itch.io that you would like me to look at, emphasis on free, let me know. Or if there's just a rag game on itch that you like, that you would like me to do a video about, let me know. I will sprinkle them in here and there among the random games. I think the last time I checked, there are about 4,000 free random Windows games on itch, so I should be here a while. Or at least I have plenty of options to choose from. So let's go on ahead and fire up the first game. I didn't open this game at all except to add it to OBS. So I saw that this game is made in Unity, and I saw the Unity personal edition splash screen, but that's it. And the screenshot on the itch website. That's all the information I have about this game. Let us begin. Super Treeman! Exclamation point. Alright, digging it. I hope this isn't a copyrighted version of La Cucaracha. I guess that's the thing about playing random games that you download from a website. I mean, I'm just launching an .exe file, you know? This could be a virus. I could be launching something that just immediately shows me some sort of shock image. You know, who knows? That video obviously wouldn't be uploaded, but yeah, there could be copyrighted music, or I could run an .exe file that just kind of shows me all the Star Wars, you know? You never know with... I mean, not that I'm expecting that, but I actually don't know if there's any vetting process at all. You can report games if they have inappropriate content, I assume, but I don't think anyone's monitoring the thousands and thousands of uploads just to make sure that they're all on the up and up. So we have a cockroach here, which is appropriate. We have a hippie, I would assume. This is a lumberjack. Would this be Super Treeman? He sort of has a bird nest on his head, and he has branches growing out of him. And we have some Atari 2600 backgrounds here with... I'm going to guess MS Paint for the art, which is fine. I should emphasize that my goal with this series is not to shit on people's games. This isn't a LOL look at, you know, the inexperienced noobs trying to make games series. You know, I'm not about that. I'm about positivity. And as long as your games aren't trying to shit on anybody, then I won't shit on your game. This could be trying to shit on hippies, which, I mean, there aren't that many hippies around anymore, I guess, but still, that's not really that cool. I like hippies. But we'll see. We'll see what the actual game is like. I will offer constructive criticism. Okay, so looks right off the bat, we have mouse controls and WASD. So, I turn into a tree, I think. And I have lumberjacks chopping me. I don't know what just happened. I had roaches flying at me. And I had sun. Well, I could sort of manipulate the roaches, it looked like. Okay. So I'm a tree during the day. Oh, I see. We have a day-night cycle here. Okay, that's awesome. So I need to collect the suns, maybe? And maybe I need to pick up the cockroaches and put them over the lumberjacks to maybe keep them from dropping me down. I'm throwing what appears to be hamburgers? Okay, so... Okay, the lumberjacks don't seem to care that much about the roaches. My score is minus 200, which... I'll be honest, that doesn't seem that great. Game over, my score is minus 200. I'm not sure if my game is over because time ran out or because my score just got too low. I can load the main menu or escape to quit the game. Okay. Well, let's load the main menu here. Alright, let's try another run here. Okay, so it's day one. So, I have to be honest, I was not expecting a day-night cycle in this game. That's kind of mind-blowing. Okay, so what am I supposed to do during the day? I click on the suns, right? Do I just have to get rid of the cockroaches? Like, oops, I clicked outside the window. Okay. My score is minus 50, and I'm... Oh, God. Okay, I'm not really sure why. I'd say this projectile is not very satisfying. Roach... Okay, so I'm getting points when I click on the suns. I like this tune. Hopefully it's not copyrighted. Okay, so I made it to day three. I'm not sure what that bar at the top of the screen is either. It's going up when I click on the suns. Is that my health? Could be my health. If it is, I'm not doing so great. I like how the little bird's nest bounces up and down on your head when you move. That's pretty cool. So the suns give me points and they restore a little bit of health. Okay. So yeah, when I said I wouldn't shit on people's games, I will of course offer constructive criticism. And... Oh, okay, so my game was over because I died. Okay, that makes sense. I just didn't notice the health bar the first time. Hey, at least my score was in the black this time. That's better than I did last time. Okay. So yeah, the animations are actually quite charming. At least for the tree man and the lumberjacks. The hippies don't really seem to do that much. I guess their peace signs kind of wiggle around. Maybe I just need to keep the roaches away from me. Do they do anything when they touch me? 28. It looks like they might have been damaging me. I don't know if there's a way to keep the lumberjacks from damaging you during the day, though. So I can keep the roaches away. I can click the suns. Maybe the lumberjacks aren't supposed to be there during the day. This seems kind of like it's meant to be a completely different system. Like, sort of a mini-game within the game. Okay, my score is minus 150, which isn't great. Okay, so the lumberjack is definitely... I can't click on the lumberjack, make him go away or anything. I didn't determine if the roaches heal you or hurt you. All I know is they... Oh, God. Okay. So, criticism number one, the projectiles don't seem that effective. Having to click the mouse over and over again, and sometimes the projectiles don't come out. That's a little frustrating, and... When the lumberjacks, when four of them appear out of nowhere and start chopping you down, that's... And it feels like there's not much you can do about it. That's a little frustrating. Also, when you can't get around them in any way. Okay, so I 365. Okay, so the roaches do 5... Well, that one did. Wait, that might be 350. Okay, so yeah, the roaches do 5 points of damage every time. Lumberjacks do... Looks like 10 or 15. Okay, I somehow ended that one with a positive score. Not sure how I did that. Okay, let's try one more time here. See, how far have I... How long have I survived? Like, day 3 or something? I hope I'm not supposed to... interact with the hippies in some way. I mean, I'm just killing them. I assume you're supposed to. I mean, the game description does say protect yourself from lumberjacks and hippies. It's kind of interesting how your health bar starts out only halfway full. I wonder if anything happens if you fill it up to 5,000. I mean, it looks like the only way to do that is to click the suns, though. And with lumberjacks able to hit me during the day and me not able to do anything to defend myself. See, the fact that the cursor changes from a crosshair to a hand kind of backs up my theory that this is meant to be, like, a different section. Like, I don't think the lumberjacks are supposed to be here during the day. I think it's more of a, sort of like a PopCap-style game, where you, what was that one with the fish? Like, Insane Aquarium? I think, like, it's sort of an idle game, where you don't really do much, you just kind of click on things and it's relaxing. Like, I think the day is supposed to be that, and then the night is supposed to be the twin stick shooter, but having the lumberjacks here during the day kind of puts a damper on the whole relaxation thing. I'm trying to determine if there's, like, anywhere else I can go besides the screen. I'm trying other buttons, I'm trying the right mouse button, I'm trying, okay, let me try one more time and just try a few different buttons. Enter, number keys, no. I mean, there were no actual instructions, I just kind of sussed out that I need to... use WASD to move around. I actually don't know how my score is going down. Doesn't seem... to go down when I take damage. I think the hippies have some sort of effect on my... Do I lose score when I kill the hippies? Are the hippies good? Maybe that's the case. Maybe the hippies are supposed to protect me from the lumberjacks in some way. Yeah, I don't know what was causing my score to go down. There's no help file or anything, is there? No, I guess not. Okay, so I touch the hippie, and it blinks. Well, it. I shouldn't say it. That's. They blink. The hippie blinks. Nothing else really seems to happen. But I'm not killing the hippies. Okay, so yeah. Killing the hippies is definitely bad. They're like the civilian targets in the shooting range simulator that police use, apparently. Where you have cardboard cutouts of bad guys, and you're supposed to shoot them because murdering bad people is fine. Because, you know, you're a cop, and obviously you're able to tell the good guys from the bad guys, but don't shoot the lady with the baby, or the little grandma. I mean, I'm giving them burgers, so you would... Maybe I'm not actually shooting them, maybe the reason I'm losing score is because they're vegan, and they just don't like the fact that I'm throwing burgers at them. Maybe I'm giving these lumberjacks burgers to placate them and make them not want to chop me down. And other than reducing your score, the hippies don't really seem to have much of a purpose other than to get in your way. Right, I'm trying to click on these things as fast as I can. Okay. Give this one more shot here. Well, I'm glad I figured out the burger dynamic in this game, because, I mean, obviously it makes sense that, you know, a hippie wouldn't be happy if you just threw a burger at them. Maybe what you're supposed to do is make sure there are no lumberjacks on the screen when day comes. Maybe if there's a hippie on the screen when I actually turn into a tree, that'll help me in some way. Okay. No, the lumberjacks still kind of appear off screen sometimes. I'm not sure if that's a bug, or if that's intentional, or if there's just something I'm missing, actually. My bet is on, well, really, I think it's even odds for any of those three. Yeah, I wish there was something I could do about these lumberjacks when I'm a tree. But I guess that's why it sucks to be a were-tree. Yeah, lumberjacks just assaulting you from all sides, and there's not a whole lot you can do about it. Alright, well, this has been Super Tree Man, I think. Yeah, Super Tree Man, or Treeman. Definitely some potential here. I would maybe hammer out a little bit of the issues with the shooting. Doesn't feel that great. The actual moving around and stuff felt fine. But the lumberjacks kind of appearing out of nowhere and just not knowing what to do, I would do something about that. Actually, let me just check real quick and make sure there's not a help file of some sort with this game, or an instruction file. No, just a bunch of Unity assets. Okay, well, good effort, Super Treeman. I give your game negative 100 hamburgers out of negative 100, and I don't actually know if that's a good score or not. I mean, it reduces to the same thing that 10 out of 10 reduces to, you know? Fractionally, they're both 1. So, yeah, I guess that's an effective game. And these lumberjacks are jerks. More like lumber jerks, am I right? Okay, well, that's been Super Treeman. Tune in tomorrow for hopefully an equally exciting game on itch.io. See you then.